Hello everyone, I'm Rochisha Agarwal, third year student of Integrated MSc Physics. I'm here to present the code on 8085 simulator of sum of only even numbers in an array. So what is the explanation of the problem? We are given with an array of elements and also the total number of elements in this array. We have to find the sum of only even numbers in this array. So first we have to check if the number is even or odd, and then we store it into another store all of them by adding each one in another memory element. So let's take an example of this problem. We have the number of elements in the array at the address 3000H and then all the memory elements at 3001H to 3004H, which are 1H, 2H, 3H, 4H respectively. Now we'll check if the numbers in the array are even or odd. So we know that 1 and 3 are odd, so we only sum 2 and 4H, which will give us 6H. So moving on to the flowchart of the program. First we'll start the program and store the number of elements in the register C and the address of the first number of array in the HL pair. Then we'll initialize the sum of even numbers as 00H. Then we'll check if C is not equals to 0. If this comes out to be false, like that C is equal to 0, then we'll store A at some memory location and end the program. But if it is true, we'll store the data pointed by HL pair in the accumulator, check if A and 01 is 0. If it is true, we basically take the sum of the number and store it to B, and increase the pointer and decrease the counter, and again move on to check if C is equal to 0 or not. So what is the explanation of the algorithm? First we have to load the number of elements in accumulator and then move it to register C. Initialize the register B, which is the sum of all the elements, with 0, and the HL pair with the address of first element in the array. Store the number pointed by HL pair in the accumulator. Check if A and 01H is 0 or not. If yes, add the number in accumulator to B. If not, skip. Then increment the pointer and decrement the counter. If counter is not 0, go to the step 3 and repeat the algorithm again. If yes, then terminate the program. Moving on to the mnemonics of the program. First, mnemonic is LDA 3000H, which is loading the accumulator with the contents of the memory 3000H, which is basically the number of elements in the array. Move the contents of accumulator to register C by the mnemonic MOVCA. Then MVI B00H, move immediately the value 00H to B. LXI H 3001H, load the address 3001H to HL pair. MOV AM, move the contents of memory to accumulator. Then check if ANI 01H, which is basically A and 01H, is 0 or not. If it is 0, then continue with the program. If 1, then skip it and come down to increasing the pointer and decreasing the counter. If it is 0, then add the sum into B by MOV AB, add M, MOV BA, which is A is equals to B, add m, b is equals to a. Then inx h point to the next location, dcrc decrease the counter by 1. Now check if the counter is 0 or not. If it is not 0, then jump to the loop. If it is 0, then store the contents of the accumulator to 3010h by STA3010h and terminate the program. So moving on to the code in GNU Simulator. So I have implemented the program in GNU Sim 8085 microprocessor simulator. So I have so this is our array of 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is the array of 4 elements specified here, and I have written the program as discussed in the mnemonic slide. So let's execute this program line by line. So first we load the data in 3000H in the accumulator, which is 4. Then we move it to C. Then we update the value of B as 00H. Then we point the HL pair to 3001H, which is the address of the first element of the array. Then we move the memory location to the accumulator, which is 01, and we AND it with 1 if it comes out to be if it comes out to be 1, we skip it and basically move here and increment the pointer and decrement the counter. So now our counter is 3 and our pointer is pointing to the next memory, which is 3002H. And then we check if this if C is equals not equals to 0. So we move on again to the loop. Now we move the memory value in the accumulator, which is 2. We map it to 01. It's 0, so we will continue with the program. Add the sum into the register B. Now we can we'll see that the register B is updated with the value 02H. Moving on to and then we'll increment the pointer and decrement the pointer. So this is this will happen for similarly for 3 and 4 as well. Now we can see that the final value we have in the accumulator is 06, which is the sum of the values which we'll store in the address 3010H. So if we load the value 3010H in our memory location, we'll find the data 6. So here is the very basic example for the implementation of the program. I'll take one more. Now moving on to the more complicated array, we have the array given here with the values with the given values. Now we'll execute this program. And check if we got an answer. Let's first calculate the sum, 14, and it's 18 and 28 should be the sum. And remember, here the values are in decimal, and but in 8085 we use the hex values instead. So we can we see that we got the right answer, which is very yeah. So thank you for seeing this video. I hope you like it. Thank you.